In this video, we'll take a look at how to integrate Make.com with apps that don't have an API. For example, Substack does not have a public API, meaning that there's no easy way for you to capture each individual subscriber and pass them through some form of automation, for example, to save them in a separate leads database. So I've been writing on Substack for almost half a year now, and I've always wanted to be able to send additional messages to my subscribers apart from the ones that I'm sending through Substack. For example, once in a while, I will publish a free downloadable resource and I just want to be able to share it to my entire email list. In order to do that, I would have to go into Substack, export my entire list, import it together with my other leads in a separate database, and then send an email. And every time I publish something new, I would have to go through this same exercise again. And I really wanted to automate this so I'll be able to easily share additional resources with everyone on my email list, including my Substack subscribers. As I mentioned, Substack does not have a public API, and there are no plans to make one available. However, they send you an email with each new subscriber, and I started thinking, how can I use Make.com to capture the subscriber data from this email? Through some trial and error, I came up with a scenario that actually works, so let's go to Make.com and take a look. What I wanted to do is grab each email and add it to my Sendy instance. This is where I send promotional emails. As you know, every time you have a new subscriber on Substack, you receive this email. Sometimes they have image and a name if they have a Substack account, but it can just be the email. What I wanted to do is essentially capture that and use Make to extract the email and the name if it's there, so that I can save those leads in a separate place. To do that, from my main inbox, I created this filter here in Gmail that if the email matches a sender from Substack and the subject new free subscriber, then it would forward it to another Gmail account that I use for all my automations. This is how the email would look when it comes to this other account. And every day at 7:30 a.m., I would have this scenario run, get all those emails, process them, and add them to my Sendy instance and also to my table of leads that they maintain in Airtable. Let's run it. Has a new email that I just forwarded. And you see what it first does is it tries to parse the email, and it does that via this text parser from here. And I'm using the match pattern, and I have this regex pattern. And the way I came up with this, because I don't know regex, and probably some of you that understand how regex works may look at this and think that it's dumb or that there's a much better way. But what I usually do in such circumstances is I copy the text version of one of the emails and I ask ChatGPT, I want to identify this here, the email, how do I do that? You can see here that I had to go back and forth, did a few tests, and essentially came up with this version that that has been working pretty good for now. I'm running this every morning, looking for this subject line, new free subscribers to Minty Analyst, grabbing codals, using this regex to parse the email from the text content of each message. And I'm doing the same thing to parse the name, where I have another regex pattern that I came up with via ChatGPT. The thing here is that sometimes there's no name, so it would just grab something else that follows this estimated source and is on the next line. So I use ChatGPT and just saying, you're great at guessing if a string is an actual name or not, and to reply with yes or no. And I'm passing the name that I'm parsing here so that I can use ChatGPT to figure out whether it managed to get a name or not. I then pass that to Airtable, and I'm using the email to search if this user has already been added to my database from somewhere else, because I have a few sources that I'm saving in the same database. After that, I'm using the Airtable absurd record, which pretty much says if it managed to find the record, then use this record's ID, so I'll be updating the record. Otherwise, don't return anything here for a record ID, and that way a new record will be generated. I'm passing the email, I'm not passing the name right here because I'm still not sure if it's a real name. And I'm also adding a source, and I have this column in my Airtable database, which I have here, and it shows where I got each email. So for example, this here is someone that signed up for my free course. This here is someone that downloaded the lead magnets. This here is someone that downloaded one of my freebies on Gumroad. And this is the one that we just processed, the Substack subscriber. I also add the date, and now I have a record. Here I have a router that does two things. So first, it checks if the name is real, its real name. It grabs the response from ChatGPT, checks if it's yes, and if it's yes, then the name was real. So it's updating the same record that we either updated or created in the previous step, and it's adding the name. On the other hand, it goes to Sendy, which is my email marketing platform, and it gets the subscriber status. It connects to a list and is looking for the email address. If it doesn't find it, it throws an error, which comes here and resumes the whole process. I have a router here because I was planning to add a few additional steps, but didn't need them. And I have a filter here that checks if the person is subscribed. So if the status is not subscribed, so this email is not within this list, then it is Sendy to add the name and the email. And one thing that I'm missing in this scenario is the name actually doesn't flow from here to here, so I need to update that and incorporate this check before I pass everything to Sendy. But I had some issues getting it to work if I was doing the checking within the Airtable node here. That's why I separated it down here. The whole idea why I'm sharing this is just wanted to show you how in some circumstances you don't have a Substack app in make.com and you don't have a lot of apps, but there's almost always a way to figure out how to bypass that and how to think a bit more creatively in order to get the information that you need. So this here is for a Substack email and grabbing the name, but in theory, you can apply this concept to pretty much anything that doesn't have an API but sends an email. So any notification that you receive over email, you can apply the same process and get it to work. As you can see, make.com is a really powerful automation system that allows us to use some tricks here and there to be able to interact with apps that do not have a public API. Ever since I signed up for Make and started to put in some time and effort and finding those little daily tasks that I do over and over again and I can easily automate, it has been a real time saver. And now, as I'm getting a bit more advanced with Make, I'm trying to figure out those like more niche scenarios where I can achieve higher value through automation, even though I have to spend more time researching and testing things out and figuring the scenarios out. Now, I also have some great examples of how you can automate daily workflow tasks, and you can take a look at those in the video up here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in this video.